Friends across the globe, my greetings. We very deliberately and consciously chose the theme of this interaction, Responsible AI for Social Empowerment, RAISE for short. It is very assuring to note that it has generated such extraordinary interest globally, and as Amitabh rightly said, 60,000 participants from 139 countries are participating. Our Prime Minister is passionate about transforming the life of ordinary Indians through the power of technology. And when he gave us the theme of Digital India, 6 years down the line, we see how it has improved governance. Be it digital delivery of services, direct benefit transfer, e-hospital, digital market for farm produce, or digital literacy or digital payment. Just to give one example to our friends from across the globe who are listening to this digital interaction. In the direct benefit transfer, we have transferred close to $172 billion into more than 370 million bank account of the poor for various welfare measures. And we have saved close to $23 billion, which used to be pocketed by middlemen and fictitious claimants. Direct improvement of good governance and good delivery. From digital literacy to healthcare, Ayushman Bharat digitally being managed, to GST, general sales tax, being digitally managed, to millions of Indians getting digitally literate in the digital literacy program, and about 10.6 million farmers using e-market to sell their farm produce, all is an indication in that direction. Technology keeps on evolving. Its pace and speed overtakes us, at times overwhelms us. But we welcome AI because it has enormous potential to generate development and also bring in further equity and delivery. Ladies and gentlemen, we are very clear about one thing. AI would become meaningful only when it brings in a palpable improvement in the quality of life of ordinary Indians. Therefore, if Digital India was for digital inclusion, we also want AI to further promote that inclusive character of development. And we are very clear that the extraordinary human resource of India, of demographic dividend, which we have been able to leverage over the years, India's IT company becoming globally competitive, we are very, very sure that our artificial intelligence ecosystem is going to promote a large pool of skilled professional who will be there to manage India's AI ecosystem and also the world. We see in that direction. We have no problem if our friends who are managing AI, a startup or corporate, create more, serve more, deliver more, and earn more. But for us, the real meaning of AI would be when it helps to bring cheers, a smile on the life of common people. And I am very proud to share with you, ladies and gentlemen, that our Prime Minister clearly told us that we must apply AI in a very substantial way to improve governance, the processes. In 2018, we came with the idea of our whole team of AI. We have set up many centers of excellence in the entire country, where new startup incubation, sectoral solutions and intellectual properties have been created. we want to further augment this process. Yes, we are a country of only 1.3 billion plus people, yet our digital profile is also very, very impressive. India is home to only 1.21 billion mobile phone users. Our digital identity, Aadhaar, is now aggregating 1.26 billion. India's internet is close to 700 million. Our Prime Minister gave us a vision that not only the towns, we need to reach all the villages of India in a mission mode manner to connect fiber to all the villages in 1,000 days. And we are speedily executing it. Obviously, India's young population and the tech-savvy people are going to generate a lot of data. We have already set up a data protection law after the widest consultation possible. It is awaiting parliamentary scrutiny in a select committee. It is going to be finally passed by the parliament very soon. It is a fine amalgam of ensuring data privacy, data safety, data security, and also data innovation and data empowerment. And most important, giving a big fillip to data economy, which India is poised to offer. These are some of the initiatives we have taken for AI. I'm very sure that our theme of digital inclusion will also be reflected in artificial intelligence inclusion, an inclusive society. And I have not the slightest idea that, as the Prime Minister said, let us bridge the digital divide always. From digital India to digital AI, this bridging the divide will continue, and India's application of AI will become a beacon for the world. I have not the slightest hesitation that this fine collection of international minds in the coming 5 days is going